Would you like to use a QuickBooks Online tool that will make editing transactions very easy? Well, then you should watch this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course using registers for owner's investment transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What are register windows? Well, a register is a window that both shows the transactions that are listed and recorded in the account in the chart of accounts, and a window that allows you to record transactions directly into that account. It was made to look like the old register books from the days of bookkeeping before the computer. You can see every transaction listed, and you can edit or add a transaction right there in the same window. And if you do that, then you will be able to see the change in the balance of the account immediately. So, you would open each one of them from the chart of accounts window that we learned about earlier in the course. You can edit any transaction you see just by clicking on it. And the data fields in each line of the register are the same as in the windows that we originally used to record these transactions. The advantage to using the register window instead of what we used before, like the deposit window, the check window, the expense window, and credit card, and so forth, you see, the advantage is that you can see the running balance as you record and enter each transaction in this window. So let's take a look. You should click the cog wheel and you go all the way across to where it says chart of accounts. Now, you can view the register for most of the accounts in the chart of accounts. Any account that is simply income and expense, you can only run a report. But the other accounts of the different types, you can open in a register window. For example, look at Cash and Chase Bank. We can click View Register, close this little hint, and you can see here, let's stretch this a bit, and you can see that starting from January 1, there are two lines in the register window for each of the transactions that we have recorded into this account, the account called Cash and Chase Bank. Remember back on January 1, we had the first deposit from Alan? Remember back on January 5th, we wrote our first check? Notice how the running balance changes. So if somebody asks you, what is the balance on a specific date? You can look in the date column and go across to the balance, and you will know the balance on that specific date. Also, you notice that there's two lines for every one transaction. And if you click anywhere in the two lines, you will be able to edit any of the fields of data that are in this transaction. Remember, in the original payment window that we recorded this payment to Ned's Taxi, we had a field to put in the name, the expense account, the transaction number, date, and money amount. So these are all the same fields that were in that original window, except they're squashed into these two little lines. Click Cancel. If you go up and click any of the transactions in any of the registers, once you change the money amount, the running balance will change immediately, and all of the other balances going forward will change because the running balance depends on previous balances. That's the way the old register style books used to look like in the days before the computer. You should also know that you can go back Well, there's a quick way. You can open up from this pull down any other account in the chart of accounts that has available a register window. For example, if we wanted to look at the American Express credit card, that's one way of opening it up. We could have clicked COG, chart of accounts, and gone down to the American Express card and clicked view register to open it up. So now we're looking at all of our credit card charges, credits, and payments all in one window. But again, the two advantages here is that you can see the running balance after each transaction, and you can look at it and change it at the moment that you're looking at the entire account and the running balance. Now, you may well ask, why do we learn registers in a crash course? And the reason is that there are two types of transactions that need to be recorded in the register window of the account called owner's investment. One of them is when the owner pays a business expense from his or her non-business personal account. And the second is when an owner brings a personal non-business asset from home into the business to be used for business purposes. So let's consider the first example. Let's imagine on January 19th of 2022, Vonda paid Rhonda's repair shop $500 for a business-related repair. Her personal check number was 1785. So what will be the result? Well, repair expense will increase by $500 because we just paid for more repair, and it will become $1,700. And because that money came from the owner's pocket, from their personal account into the business, that $500 increases the owner's investment to $700. And this is what the trial balance should look like after we record this transaction. From the top right, we click the cog wheel and we go over and click chart of accounts. We scroll down to the account that says owner's investment and go across to the right. Then click view register. Now notice the only transaction in this register is the one we made in the prior video for $200. So we click add journal entry. Add journal entry, and we have to put in the check number as the document number for this transaction. The date will be January 19th of 2022. And the person whom we paid was Rhonda's repair shop, and the reason we paid was for repair expense. Let's just go up here, repair expense. Now, is owner's investment increasing or decreasing? Well, the account we are in is increasing. So we put the $500 in the increase column because we have both more owner investment from personal to business, and we also have more company repair expense for the business repair that Rhonda just did. When we click save, you notice the balance does increase to the $700 we predicted. But the best place to look at this is to click reports and then go to the trial balance, and you can see the numbers are exactly as what we predicted. The owner's investment balance is now a total of $700, and repair expense has increased to $1,700. Example 2. On January 20 of 2022, Vonda brought to the office a piece of video equipment to be used only for business from this point forward. The fair market value of the equipment on January 20 is $1,000. You can add a new account on the fly. That means that you can add a list item like a chart of account accounts or a vendor name at the moment that you make the transaction. And what will be the result? Well, equipment, the new account, will show up for the first time as $1,000 because that was the value of the equipment at the moment that Vonda brought it to the office. And because it came from the owner to the business, owner's investment will also increase by $1,000 and become $1,700. Again, we click the cog wheel, go to chart of accounts, scroll down to the owner investment account, and click view register. Now you could add you click in the register and you could add a transfer instead of a journal entry if you're bringing a fixed asset. So click transfer and now you have a new fresh open field to record this transaction. Now, the date of the transfer was January 20 of 2022. And there is no payee in this case, but the account that represents the reason why you're making this transaction or increasing the owner's investment is not yet on the list. So you scroll to the top and click Add New. And we're right back in the Add Account to the Chart of Accounts window that we learned about in the beginning of the course. The type is fixed asset, and the detail type can be some kind of equipment. And if it doesn't say equipment, it doesn't matter what you choose. I would choose furniture and fixtures and change the name to all caps, because the detail type in this case is not relevant. We click Save and Close, and now we know that the owner's investment is changing because there's a change in the company equipment. Question: is the account we are in increasing or decreasing? We are in the owner's investment account, and the owner's investment account is increasing because more is being invested into the company, $1,000 worth of equipment. After we click Save, we can click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Owner's investment increased to $1,700, and equipment showed up for the first time as $1,000.